Namaste students, today you are going to learn the concept of parameter with type. So in the previous class I explained about the parameter without type. So in the example parameter without type, they are not mentioned the data type, they just given the parameter variable only. So here parameter with type example requires colon b is greater than or equal to 0, returns colon a to the power of b. Let r e c pow a colon int b colon int equal to, if b equal to 0 then 1, else a asterisk pow b of a minus 1. So in the first line requires, so I already explained in the concept of parameter without type, requires is a precondition and returns is a postcondition. So how we can say requires, that is the condition before the condition what they are given, that is the precondition. After the condition what they are given, that is the postcondition. So let is a keyword, or is the recursive. So power a colon int. So what do you mean by a? A is the parameter, that is variable we are saying, no, parameter. A is the parameter. And what do you mean by int? Int is the data type. Int is the data type. So we are closely related to the concept parameter with data type. So what do you mean by b? B is also a parameter and int is the data type. So what is the next line? If b equal to 0, that is condition, if b equal to 0 then it return the value 1. If suppose b is not equal to 0, this condition it becomes false, means it moves to the else condition, a asterisk pow b of a minus 1. Here we have to change, in the book also they are given b of a minus 1, we have to change a of b minus 1, because in the third line what they are given, that is sorry, second line what they are given, a to the power of b. So here we have to change a b minus 1. So in the book also we have to change. So here when we write the type annotation, that is when we write the type annotation, so for a and b the parenthesis are mandatory. Parenthesis, this bracket only we are saying parenthesis, the parenthesis are mandatory. Generally we can leave out these annotations, because it's simpler to let the compiler infer them. So there are times we may want to clearly write down the types, this is useful on times when you get a type error from the compiler. So when you get a type error from the compiler, that does not make any sense. So clearly annotating the types can help with debugging such an error message. So let us see the syntax of how to define a function. So let rec fn, fn is a function, rec is the recursive, a1 up to so an equal to k. So here let is a keyword, what do you mean by rec? Rec is also a keyword, that is recursive keyword. Rec is also a keyword. Fn is a function. So here if fn is a recursive function, then we can be mentioned the rec, otherwise it may be omitted. If fn is a recursive function, so the keyword rec is required, otherwise it may be omitted. So let is a keyword, fn is a variable indicating an identifier being used as a function name. So fn is a variable indicating being used as a function name. So the names are a1 up to so an. These are the variables indicating an identifier used as a parameter. So variables we can also say as the parameters. A1 up to so an are the parameters. So if, once again I will explain the syntax. Let is a keyword, rec is a recursive function. If fn is a recursive function, means we have to use the rec keyword, otherwise this rec we can be omitted. What do you mean by recursive function? a function definition, a function definition which call itself is called a recursive function. So I will explain the concept of recursive function in the next class. Thank you, students.